Hey, what's going on, man? It's your boy LD, aka Firm Handshake. The Lion King, I've been fucking with that. And I was thinking, like, if a thug told the story of the Lion King, how would it go? So, it'd be like this, I think. Now look at all these motherfuckers out on Pride Ride. Lot of livestock, think it's cause Sarabi ride cock, cause she did once. Cause they celebrated Simba, Lil Cup, everybody got a meal. Cause deal was lions were some motherfucking real thugs. And the fear of being turned into a meal was such a fright, yo. But on the real, they hella nice though. This specific pack of lions acting like some white folks. But Africa's full of brothers, one is Uncle Scar. And that motherfucker wasn't nothing funny, Sonny Hard. And he mad too, cause he just wanna be the man too. First it was his brother, now another king is brand new. Baboon drawing on the tree, you dig? There's something freaky about Rafiki. Bet his weed legit. That motherfucker monkey doesn't need comedians. The reason is he laughing at the breeze and shit. It's weird. Alright, now back to the plot. Mufasa was a wonderful father, he loved him a lot. And Simba wanted to impress him every second he got. The youngin' was taught, but then one afternoon he forgot. That's when he hollered at Nala to follow the Bala, to crawl up in the squalor where all of the lawless acknowledge his father. But they never gave a fuck about a little bitty pup, aw shucks. They gon' eat this motherfucker up until his dad came through and smacked them bitches in the head. Could've had him dead, but he let him run away instead. Now he really mad at dude. He cute when he sad though, and the simple truth, Simba doing what his dad do. Shit, now that's some real talk, homie. But he can't on them fields with them little paws, homie. And real dogs only bark at bitches when they gotta do. Taught him to think when he at the line like an audible. And now the part I abhor, Lil Simba chillin' with a chameleon perfecting his roar. Could've been a gecko, but that shit echoed affecting the gorge. Was accidental, but you know what's in store, the stampede scene. Shit, and he was all up on the stick, got a hold of grip. Simba, you done got up in some shit, but his dad came through and he saved the man. But as he climbed with them wounds, Moo raised his hands. But dude, his brother on some motherfucking Scarface. Scarface lit up like a motherfucking star in space. Hard place and a rock, Mufasa caught up in between that. That's his brother, but that brother was a mean cat. And when he threw him off the ledge, Simba couldn't believe that that motherfucker dead. Tears being shed, Scar got up in his head. More dread for the boys, so he ran away and fled. Timon and Pumbaa time, the young cub grown up. What a beautiful line, they grub bugs, cub nuts. Hitting puberty while the voice does change up. Ferris Bueller style, you're not. And they was trying to eat a beetle. A lion came through, trying to die hella regal. Then Pumbaa got stuck, about to get his ass cut. But then Simba stepped up and defended like a thug do. Rolling around, he realized who it was to. Holler back at Nala like, what's up, boo? Hug smooth, confused. Nala looking pretty, titties done grew, but cute. He about to fuck soon. Then he nuzzled from the back and he cut off from the front. He was really macking John. She all up on his junk. You can see me jacking off the scene, believe that. The young me fucking around with cats, I need that. To recap, lot of feedback, Simba react, the fam need that. But your man can't be back. He just wanna do his thing, you dig? But he the king, even though he wasn't feeling it. Until he met up with the monkey, what a funky fucking junkie. But he spunky, told that motherfucking lion about his country and he ran back. Pride Rock got his man back. But damn, the whole land hella ransacked. And then he saw Scar with his mom, so Robbie looking hella wan. Hidden Simba looked on, and Scar did her like a dog. Hit her hard with his palm, for real, dog. Alright, you fucking with the god now. Long growl, pimping handle business like a boss now. Toss down, talking shit to Simba about the cost clown. Scar tell the youngin' that he killed his pops though. For real, motherfucker, he revealed his hots, bro. And clocked on that motherfucking sucker with a cross. Rocked uncle with a couple, then he sunk him with a toss. He don't play that shit. Brothers in lacrosse, real talk. The dogs done finished him off. And Pride Rock was back where it started at. The meals back, fields packed with the hardest cats. For real, Jack, the animals is feeling that. The real is back, and I just spit the realest rat, you know. Simba must've hit it hella freaky. Gotta keep it PG, but you see Rafiki with the peewee, baby. That right damn meanie murkin' it right, the dope pipe. But that's just the circle of life. Hey, I was just fucking around when I said that I jerked off to the scene when Nala and Simba, like, got back together. I didn't really jerk off. I was too young. I did get hard, though. I was hard as shit. I ain't gonna lie about that. I was, you know, I didn't know why I was hard, but it just felt like the type of moment where one would be hard. So,
wanna wait to boy, cause the way I'm living life is a motherfucking joy. On some grown man B.I. I could've been a girl or any ethnicity up in the world, but I'm rolling with the top back. I ain't gotta worry where the cops at. I ain't gotta wear a fucking bra strap. Me and the crew, I'm really doing everything that we like to. Man, it's a damn good day to be a white dude.
Shit, I'm living good up in this bitch. Kiki rolling around the city, blowing good up in that weird. I ain't black or Dominican, not Hispanic or Indian, so imprisonment is not a predicament I envision for a white boy. Holla at your motherfucking kite boy. Higher than a motherfucking kite side boy. They ain't suspicious of Jews. I show contrition, it's cool. Slap on my wrist, get my daddy to choose. One of them top lawyers that be rolling around in this crew. I'm eating chopped soy and balling on a carnival cruise. That's what I do, kid. Happy that my name ain't stupid. Dave could have been Daquan with a few kids. But now I'm farting over eating the meals. If I ain't got a theme party, I don't be a good will. I'm Dennis Payne, tennis playing. Smelling on some Cabernet and I ain't gay, but if I was, everything would be okay. Look, I know I'm being condescending in my rhymes, but my premium channels mean Tyler Perry's never live. Getting tickets, they sick, I sit at the Eagle 45, where I'm eating when I'm high, where they eat at to survive.
Food chains, can't even wanna wait the boy, cause the way I'm living life is a motherfucking joy. I'm some grown man B.I. I could've been a girl or any ethnicity up in the world, but I'm rolling with the top back. I ain't gotta worry where the cops at. I ain't gotta wear a fucking bra strap. Me and the crew, I'm really doing everything that we like to.
Man, it's a damn good day to be a white dude. Yeah, it's little D, I ain't this bitch. How happy that I'm white, but relieved I ain't a chick. Yo, I never wake up and have to cake on my makeup or straighten hair. I ain't giving a damn, I'm wearing whatever I wanna in this motherfucker. They up in heels and tummy tucking, they don't grub except for taking them pills, for real. And now I'm bleed shit, I ain't gotta eat dick. I ain't bleeding about my penis, smoking the weed. I don't fall asleep because I'm chiefing in disagreements. I participate without weeping, and when I'm free, and I'm getting dabs, high fives, and all that. My reps going up, and the best hoe is slut. So what up, your boy cut up, but eat butter. And I ain't gotta speak to my mother to still love her. And I've been getting better looking with age, but like I can get who he deserves with a horrible face.
I mean, y'all seen Seal, right? That dude scarred the fuck up and dating, like, models and shit. And I bet, like, Adele's gotta date somebody who works at, like, AT&T.
I go on dates and never have to worry about getting raped. And I watch a game and never have to worry about how it's played. And I meet a babe and never have to act deliriously faking. If I impregnate, I can pack a bag and be on my way. But good luck, girl.
I can't even wanna wait to boy, cause the way I'm living life is a motherfucking joy. On some grown man B.I. I could've been a girl or any ethnicity up in the world, but I'm rolling with the top back. I ain't gotta worry where the cops at. I ain't gotta wear a fucking bra strap. Me and the crew are really doing everything that we like to. Man, it's a damn good day to be a white dude.
Yeah, I'm happy as fuck, man. First off, I'm a dude, so there was a 1 in 2 chance of that sucking. But now, I can run a 7-minute mile. I can defend myself adequately. I can be logical. I can get along with my roommates, watch serious movies without being scared by them. And then on top of that, I'm white, which is like amazing because everybody naturally assumes I'm a great person. I get a fair shot at the life that I deserve. I mean, I can underachieve my way into any college in the country. I get my hair cut at a salon. People always hold the door open for me, which is nice. I never have to get into a fight, like, for social purposes. And please don't take this as me just disparaging black people. It ain't about that. It's about me being happy that I'm white. You know what I'm saying? But on that note, can someone explain to me why Fat Joe and any other person of Hispanic descent is allowed to say the N-word? I mean, I guess it's unrelated, but, like, that shit don't make any sense. I've been thinking about that shit a lot. Because, I mean, if I could say the N-word, like, it would really help my rhyme scheme out. It's, like, the perfect filler word.
would confirm.